Hello everyone, welcome to the Geoecologist. I am Dr. Krishnanand and you have been watching my videos on climatology. So in this session, we are going to learn about a very interesting phenomena that happens in Indian Ocean. That is a dipole movement and that is called Indian Ocean Dipole. So in details, we are going to discuss that in today's session. But before we go ahead, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and also do share the videos with others as well. So in last session, we learned about the Pacific waters and some kind of dipole relationship in the Pacific, that is in Eastern and Western Pacific, under the concepts that is El Nino, La Nina, El Nino Southern Oscillation, El Nino Modoki. So now let's understand what happens in the Indian Ocean dipole situation and what is this Indian Ocean dipole all about. This dipole word itself basically means what? Any object such as magnet, polar molecule or antenna that is oppositely charged at two points. So basically polarity, that is important here. So you can have one pole which is here and the other pole which is here. So between this pole, what is this circulation happening in terms of climatology when we study? This is called dipole study. So Indian Ocean has this kind of dipole movement that we study as IOD, which is called Indian Ocean Dipole. So Indian Ocean Dipole is what? Often called Indian Nino. Remember that El Nino? So in El Nino, what used to happen? Remember? El Nino, the Eastern Pacific used to warm up, right? And Western used to become cold, which is not there in the normal circumstance. In El Nino years, the warm waters originate here, which is called El Nino, and this is what is happening. So some kind of dipole movement happened. In Indian Ocean as well, it is called Indian Nino because of the same reason that in this particular zone, that is the cross equatorial area, as you see, suppose this is the equator, and this is where you have this particular place that both the sides of equator, this is an intertropical convergence as we know, right? So ITCZ, and this is what we see is the fluctuation happening. ITCZ move north and south, right? This we already have studied in climatology. So also there is a polarity between the coastal areas. So remember, one part which is Indonesia and Australia part, which is the eastern coastal part, right? And the western is part of the Africa. So African coast and the Indonesia and Australia, Northern Australia coast. These are the two poles of Indian Ocean, if you see in that matter. And there is a movement between these two poles. So let's understand what is this dipolar movement and what happens to air as well as to water, right? So there is this particular sea surface temperature that changes across Indian Ocean, right? Now it's about temperature changes. Remember, it is also called SSTs. So SSTs is not social studies, it is sea surface temperature. So IOD measures, Indian Ocean Dipole, measures these differences between sea surface temperature, between what? Between the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal segment, right? So this is important. And when I say Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal, it is largely related to the African side and here to the Indonesia and Malaysia side. So it's kind of this particular diagonal, if we can draw. It is not this straight relationship like this. It is like a diagonal. So this is what we need to remember, what happens in this diagonal relationship. And this diagonal is drawn because of the physiography, if you look at that. So topographical feature is also important in IOD that you need to also keep into mind. So both these poles are situated within what? If you see, this is what? This entire belt is equatorial belt. Isn't it? So that is important, between 10 degree and north and 10 degree south of equator. So northwest to southeast, that is the diagonal orientation of this polarity, that is dipole. So this is, you have north and west, and this is southeast. So this is the direction of this particular dipole that you need to keep in mind. Now let's understand that how this mechanism operates in this IOD concept. So Indian Ocean Dipole effect, let's understand that not every El Nino year, remember it is also called Indian Nino, so it does not mean that every El Nino year will have the same impact in India. So Indian Ocean Dipole is defined by the difference in SSTs, that is sea surface temperature, between two areas or the poles, hence it is called dipole. So where Western Arabian Sea and Eastern Pole, that is Indian Ocean, that is east, that is south of Indonesia. So this diagonal, as we saw, and IOD develops in equatorial region of Indian Ocean, which has maximum solar insolation received, as you know, and when? During April to May time. And it starts peaking during April and May and reaches its maximum till October. And this is the time when lots of heat accumulation happens, and that is when this warming and cooling happens and this entire circulation starts happening. So temperatures in eastern part of the ocean oscillate between warm and cold. That is important. So eastern part, remember, and western part. This is the dipole movement. So northwest and southeast. If you observe, what we are talking here is that the temperatures in the eastern part ocean, so this particular part, oscillates between warm and cold compared with the western part, cycling through phases referred to as positive, neutral and negative. So there are three phases of this dipole. Remember, one is a neutral phase, a normal condition. One is a positive phase and one is a negative phase. So that is where we need to understand. And also, now you must have this idea if you have watched the previous video on El Nino. Remember what used to be this SE, that is southeastern part of this pole. This is exactly where the El Nino impact is also happening, right? During El Nino year, what happens? This area is dry. And this is eastern part of Pacific. So this area is a common area between the Indian and the Pacific Ocean, right? And that is where we are concerned, that because of the southeastern part, that is Indonesia and northern Australia part, which is affected by simultaneously this dipole as well and El Nino as well, that's why it has a common relationship. That's why many times Indian Ocean dipole is studied along with the El Nino concept, to understand how it is linked. So let's understand these phases of Indian Ocean dipole, that is positive phase, neutral phase and negative phase, to understand the mechanism. So first of all, we need to understand what is this neutral IOD phase, Indian Ocean dipole. When it is a neutral situation, what is the basic? What happens? So remember, this is your western part and this is your eastern part. And what is the flow pattern? The flow pattern is this particular way, if you observe, right? So here it keeps raining on Indonesia and Australia, northern Australia side, right? In neutral phase, this is normally cold and dry, right? So water from Pacific flows between the islands of Indonesia, as we know, and keeps this particular area warm. Remember, because in normal situation, low pressure is here. This is the warming part in Walker circulation. So this area receives lots of rainfall and moisture and all. Right? So in normal circumstances, it is a neutral phase. A neutral phase of IOD is the normal phase of Walker circulation in Pacific. It is related to that because low pressure is over Indonesian islands. So this is a warming area which has lots of moisture, which goes up, forms clouds, it rains a lot, right? So in neutral phase, rainfall is on the eastern pole. Right? So air rises above this area and falls over western half of Indian Ocean. Now air rises, obviously. There is a warming situation here. So what will happen? This is a very common thing, that air will rise up, it will rain, and this dry cold air will subside here, and again this flow will continue. So this keeps happening, right? So temperatures are close to normal across Indian tropical ocean. So this is tropical Indian Ocean, right? The equatorial tropical part, as we know. And hence neutral IOD results in little change to Australia's climate. So in neutral phase, even there is no change in Australia side because it remains normal. So this is a neutral normal phase, right? Now, when we look into this positive side of IOD, now remember, whenever I say LHS and RHS, remember this particular thing, that when it is positive, LHS and this RHS, if you say high pressure and low pressure, if you can remember your left hand side and right hand side. So left is when you have warming on left, that is dominating and which is positive. So this is what you need to fix in your mind, that divide Indian Ocean into plus and minus, as simple, right? So if plus is on your LHS, left hand side, it is a positive phase. But if this plus travels to this side, that we study in the negative phase. So first now, let's understand that what is this positive phase? The positive means more insulation, more heating, more warming on this side, that is on your western part, right? So this is called positive phase. And why? See, where there is a warming, the air will travel there, moisture will rise up, and lots of rain and thunderstorms will occur on this coast, this particular area, right? So westerly winds weaken. Remember now, what is the situation here? This is a tropical Indian Ocean And what happens here at this particular time, what you see is this westerly winds, right? They weaken up and along the equator, allowing warm water to shift towards Africa. So this is where the warm water starts shifting towards Africa, and changes in the winds also allow cool water to rise up from the deep ocean in the east. Now upwelling starts at this coast. Now remember that this is area where upwelling starts and this is warm area. Right, so this is important. The cycle starts to move like this. The water rise up from here, it goes like this, right? And this particular area has warm waters, this area has cool water, and this is how this entire cycle starts to operate. And here the air near the surface is warmed up, lots of cloud formation, dry air again goes here and subsides down. So this is a positive phase of IOD. So what happens here in this positive phase? Simply, if you want to know this, see, this sets up a temperature difference across the tropical Indian Ocean. So this is warm, this is cool. Then obviously you understand that from where to where the circulation will start happening. So this is where the entire circulation shifts, right? So generally this means that less moisture where? On this coast. And that is where no rain, it is completely dry, West Australian coast. Right, so this is important, and which is wet part? The African coast is completely wet because of this positive IOD. Right, so this changes the path of weather systems coming from Australia's west, often resulting in less rainfall and higher than normal temperatures. So this is important to remember that this positive phase is positive for whom? For African side, and it is actually negative for the Australian side, which actually has no rainfall. So it is basically positive in context to my left hand side, that I always need to remember because many people get confused. So positive means plus on your left, right? And negative is basically this particular area. So this is how a dipole is. Now if I say that reverse this, make positive this side and negative this side. So what will happen? It will become negative IOD phase. Now look here what happened. Now earlier this was plus. This plus now shifts here with time. Right? So plus is here now. So what happens? Here it is minus. So this normal situation is now changed to positive, where this is accumulation here. Now this accumulation shifts here. That's where plus goes. Plus is adding. So remember, plus sign on left means now it is positive phase. Plus sign on right, it is means that it is negative phase. As simple. So this is how you need to remember that which portion has the addition. So westerly winds intensify here, allowing warm waters to concentrate near Australia. Now this is where this is coming from the west, right? This sets up a temperature difference across again. And now this particular area, you see Australian coast, it has lots of warming happening and then increased convection. So again, this will have intense rainfall and the cycle changes here, right? The movement changes here. So this is how this dipole operates. So this is important to remember as the negative IOD phase. Now this is negative in interpretation as well to what? This area is completely left dry because of this, right? Now this is a completely wet. So positive IOD means who's gaining? My left hand side of Indian Ocean. That is what African coast is gaining. Negative IOD means who's gaining? The Australian side, Indonesian side is gaining. So always remember this plus and minus. If you remember this, you'll never forget this concept of IOD. Plus on left is basically positive. And just the opposite, if it changes, plus and minus is reverse, it means negative IOD. So always write plus and minus from left to right and then analyze the Indian Ocean map, and then you can remember it forever. So again, let's take this diagram and understand a few more points, that with a positive IOD, winds over Indian Ocean blow from east to west. That is very common, right? From east to west that you see the wind blowing, right? And this results in Arabian Sea, that is Western Indian Ocean near African coast, being much warmer, and Eastern Indian Ocean around Indonesia become cold and dry. So remember, this is the positive IOD phase. And in negative dipole year, what will happen? This will shift. So this area will have lots of warming and lots of rain. Now, if you say what is the linkage between Indian monsoon to this IOD, can you figure it out? I believe you have figured it out till now. So remember, this is where this jet stream brings the air to Indian Ocean. So if it is a positive IOD phase, remember, Indian monsoon will have more moisture content. right? So positive IoT phase will impact more rains will come to India in monsoon situation. But if it is a negative IoT phase, less rain because this area is dry. So not much of moisture will be available for the monsoon to get into India. So that is where this positive and negative is important. So positive actually is positive for our monsoons as well. That is also another connotation to remember. So positive warming on this particular front, that is western part. So positive IOD, it means results in more cyclones than usual in Arabian Sea. And also remember, it is good for heavy rains on this particular side. But if it is negative IOD, where is the cyclogenesis happening? Cyclones are more happening on this side. But general pattern is also that this area has more moisture because it is a low pressure belt in normal Walker situation. So you find that this Bay area, Bay of Bengal area, has most of the times more cyclone occurring, right? So now you could relate to the cyclone occurrence or cyclogenesis that in Arabian Sea, because of this normal Walker cell that is here, this is always low pressure in most of the year. Only in El Nino year it reverses. So most of the time you have this Bay of Bengal area getting more temperature and moisture and more cyclone formation in this portion. And Arabian Sea has mostly this drought prone areas on the coast that you see in African coast and Arabian coast, right? So that is mostly there, right? That's why it is called negative phase for this IOD. Right? So negative in terms of that you don't have moisture. Positive, it means you have more moisture, you have more temperature. That is the simple way to understand. So I hope you understand this positive, negative and neutral phase of this IOD. So positive IOD means it is on the west, which is plus, right? And negative IOD means it is on the east, which is plus. And what is plus? The amount of heat that also leads to amount of rainfall, moisture changes, right? And also one factor that is related to it is cyclone formation in the tropical oceans. And as we know that Indian Ocean has lots of tropical cyclone on this side. So mostly what you see is that this area is impacted by this kind of negative IOD as we know in the Indian Ocean. So now, when we have understood about Indian Ocean Dipole, its relationship with the El Nino and how it impacts the Indian monsoon, in the sessions to come, we are going to learn more on climatology and related topics. So stay tuned, stay safe, all the best.